These breast cancer survivors are taking their fight to the mat at American Dragon Martial Arts in Hooksett. These are just some of Dr. Roshini Patel's Pink Warriors. And every Wednesday night, Dr. Patel joins them, trading in her scrubs for sweats, making sure her patients are staying healthy.
Every Wednesday.
I know.
She's here.
I know.
Yeah.
And she yells at you when you shouldn't be doing certain things because you have restrictions because she knows what surgeries you've been through.
You shouldn't use your hand
that high. No, don't do that.
You see, Dr. Patel is not your typical surgeon. Her office isn't confined to the hospital walls. Her focus isn't just on the disease she attacks in the operating room.
It's a tough love kind of bedside manner. But the thing is that, is, you know, all joking aside, I think that they know I really care because I am taking the time. We are taking the time to find out what's going on in their lives, to find out what may limit them from making some healthier lifestyle choices.
Dr. Patel and her team at Dartmouth-Hitchcock have looked at studies and feel strongly that they can improve the outcome for their breast cancer patients through exercise and nutrition.
If I've had a patient that has never exercised before, I just tell them to start with a pedometer or a fitness tracker and, you know, track their steps and see how they do. And then, can you add a half an hour a day of walking? Can you lift weights twice a week? You know, how, what can you do? And we just keep asking them to do a little bit more.
This was me several years ago. I weighed 320 pounds. And I've lost 160 pounds. Dr. Patel, she was a tough cookie on me, and I needed it. She planted the seeds of health and wellness. We only have one life.
Dr. Patel says that 90% of her patients listen to her advice on living a healthier lifestyle. And that, she believes, is because she has proof that it really works.
I actually can say that this is what I'm seeing with my other patients. They're coming off of these medications that are expensive. So that's also a motivating factor as well, that I actually can give them examples.
You don't realize how much support you're going to need to be a cancer patient and to come out the other side. And that's where Dr. Patel and the team come in, because they don't give you a chance to let the dark clouds even settle in with you, so they don't have to be dispelled. I mean, they're there immediately.
And it truly is a team effort.
There's many opportunities to visit with that patient. There's many opportunities to answer their questions. There's many opportunities to help guide them through this process so they don't feel lost. They don't feel necessarily overwhelmed. They feel all their questions are answered and things are dealt with in a manner that really takes probably the worst day of their life and makes it into something manageable.
From the hospital to a karate class, the YMCA, or a ballet studio, even the grocery store, Dr. Patel can be found anywhere that her patients are committed to getting healthy.
Some people think I'm a vampire. It's highly possible. I don't know. I don't sleep much. I guess I have a lot of energy.
Welcome to Hannaford at Hanover Street, and we're going to shop with the doc today. The program got started when Dr. Patel was very interested in helping her patients to find healthy foods. And when you are trying to maneuver through a supermarket, when you're either tired, confused, or absolutely overwhelmed by your diagnosis and its treatment, we need to help. She wanted to help her patients find easy to prepare foods.
Turmeric is our herb. This is the root form of it. We use this a lot in Indian cooking. We use it a lot in our meat dishes and for rice. In research land, this is thought to help prevent the blood supply to cancer cells.
Dr. Patel is the most wonderful person I've ever met, over and above being my surgeon. This woman has saved my life. No is not in her vocabulary. Her patients come first.
I mean, we do these grocery tours and learn all these great healthy eating habits. And then we have walking groups that we walk during the warmer weather. And the karate group at night, we get to go and we learn self-defense and work out. And it's like she's one of our friends. She treats us like a friend. She's not just a doctor.
Dr. Patel and her team believe that cancer care really must go beyond diagnosis, surgery, and treatment.
There you go.
We started about over 2.5 years ago. Dr. Patel actually happened to have my girlfriend as a patient, and we helped her out doing it just by coming to class here. And Dr. Patel saw her gains, how much she has gained by doing the martial arts with me. And we ended up talking, and it just gave it a try, and that's how it started.
It's a great way to really get your body back and stretch it out, and especially those areas after you've had surgery. And it's been a tremendous help in the healing process.
It definitely helped. Not only like the range of motion is great, the strengthening, it's the camaraderie, it's the not having to worry. Everybody's been through the same thing, and you don't have to explain anything. And
when they see me repeatedly out in the community at these programs, they kind of know that I'm watching them. I'm kind of keeping an eye on them.
She's recently won a national award from the American Cancer Society. She is valued by her colleagues and patients alike. But Dr. Patel says that's not why she does what she does.
My patients are getting healthier. It's going to improve their long-term outcomes. They're decreasing their risk of the cancer coming back.
And her pink warriors will keep fighting, battling breast cancer from every angle.
They're motivating each other, you know, and they're out there. It's a wonderful group of people. I'm really blessed that they trust our team with their care, and I'm really blessed to be able to take care of them.